discuss about chapter 1 of class 11, the living world. So before we start the chapter, you should have some clear idea about different terms related to biology. The first, biology itself is one term. So what is biology? It is the science of life. It is the study of living organisms. So in biology we study about different life forms and about living organisms. So it is the study, it is the science of living organisms and different life forms. Now question arises, then what is a living organism? How can we differentiate living organism from non-living organisms? Okay, so that we will discuss in our further topics. So before we go to that topic, let's discuss one new term, a new terminology, that is taxonomy. Taxonomy means the branch of biology dealing with identification, nomenclature and classification. So in taxonomy, we do identification, we do classification and we do naming of organisms, that is nomenclature. The branch of biology dealing with identification, classification and nomenclature of living organisms, this branch of biology is called taxonomy. Okay, so before we study further about taxonomy, just we will discuss about characteristics of living organisms. Okay, what are the different characteristics of living organisms and how can we define a living organism? First characteristic of a living organism is growth. What is growth? Growth can be defined as increase in size, increase in shape. So by that way we can define growth of an organism, increase in size, increase in shape or increase in number of cells. By these three ways we can define growth. So growth is one of the characteristic of living organisms. In every living organism's lifespan, growth is the main characteristic that every organism, living organisms are having. Increase in height, increase in weight, increase in number of cells. Okay, in unicellular organism, increase in number of cells is considered as growth. Remember this thing. Second property. Now listen, growth is the characteristics of, is one of the characteristics of living organism, but it is not a defining property. Make it clear. Growth is the characteristic of living organism, right? But it is not the defining property of living organism. Even a non-living thing can also grow. For example, Mount Everest height was 8848 meter previously and now it is 8850 meter. There also some accumulation processes are occurring and height of Mount Everest has now become 8850 meter. So in non-living thing also growth is occurring. So alone growth cannot define a living organism. So growth is not a defining property of living organism. Remember this thing. Next property or next characteristic of a living organism is reproduction. What is reproduction? It is the process by which an organism produces an offspring of its own kind. That is termed as reproduction. So for continuity of species, reproduction is very important. What is the importance of reproduction? Continuity of species. For continuity of species, reproduction is very important. So it is the process by which an organism produces an offspring of its own kind. Reproduction also cannot define a living organism. Why? The answer is, some living organisms cannot reproduce. for example, sterile organisms, or you can give another example of hybrid animals, hybrid organisms like mule, hybrid of horse and donkey. So these hybrid animals or any sterile human being cannot reproduce in their lifetime. So we cannot call them non-living organisms. Okay? So reproduction is also not a defining property of living organism. Okay? Make it clear. Growth and reproduction are characteristics of living organisms, right? But they alone cannot define a living organism. They are not a defining property of living organisms. Clear? Third thing. Third characteristic of living organism is that they have cells in their body. They have cellular arrangement. They have cells in their body. All living organisms are made up of cells. So cell presence is only seen in living organism. Okay, so cellular organization is found in only living organisms. It is not found in non-living organisms. So cell is the fundamental unit of life. Okay, so cell is the basic unit of life. You can say it is the structural and functional unit of life. It is the fundamental unit of life or living organisms. So cell is found only in living organisms. So this can be considered as a defining property of living organism. Is it clear? No non-living organisms have cells. Cells are present only and only in living organisms. So it is one of the defining property of living organisms. Next characteristic, metabolism. What is metabolism? All the physiological processes occurring in any living organisms, like catabolism, and anabolism. Catabolism plus anabolism constitute metabolism. So all the physiological processes or biochemical processes occurring in any living system that are called as metabolic processes, and that phenomenon is called metabolism. In any living organisms, some processes are occurring which are degradatory and some processes are occurring which are synthetic. Okay? So constructive processes are called anabolism. Destructive processes are called catabolism. If any bigger molecule is broken down into smaller molecules, that process is called catabolism. If smaller molecules combine to form bigger molecule, it is called anabolism. For example, sucrose breaks down to form glucose and fructose. And a carbohydrate, a polymer of carbohydrate polysaccharide, breaks down to form monosaccharides. That is a catabolic process. If monosaccharides combine to form a polysaccharide, it is an anabolic process. Both the processes are occurring in living organisms, and these both processes constitute metabolism. It is also a defining property for living organisms. Remember. Third thing. Third defining property of living organism is response to stimulus. Stimulus is a singular word. Stimuli is a plural word. Like a fungus is a singular word, fungi is a plural word, or fungi, whatever you call it. So response to stimuli means consciousness. Only living organisms are aware of themselves. They are conscious about their existence. So response to stimuli. All the living organisms have some sensing power. Okay, sensitivity. So that stimulus will generate some response. So they have having response to any stimulus, like touch, like temperature change. So this is also one defining property found in only and only in living organisms. These three characteristics can define a living organism. If these three characteristics are there, you can call it that thing as a living organism. Let us come to the taxonomical part. What is taxonomy? Identification, classification, nomenclature. Okay. In short form, you can remember like this: INC. Identification, nomenclature, and classification. So, who is considered as the father of taxonomy? Father of taxonomy is Carolus Linnaeus. Father of taxonomy is Carolus Linnaeus. Okay. Carolus Linnaeus, or sometimes it is referred as Carl Linnaeus. So Carolus Linnaeus is considered as the father of taxonomy. Then father of biology is Aristotle. Remember, Carolus Linnaeus is only father of taxonomy. Classification system father is Carolus Linnaeus. Father of biology is Aristotle. Okay, so don't confuse between these two. Father of biology is Aristotle. He is also considered as father of zoology. Carolus Linnaeus gave one important system, a very important system for classification of organisms, and that is binomial nomenclature system. Binomial nomenclature system of classification. Okay, he gave very important system of classification, that is binomial nomenclature system of classification, giving two names to any living organisms. Okay, we will discuss about it in our next lecture.